This video is going to cover the process of panelization of identical boards in DipTrace. Panelization is generally a post-design operation, so it's strongly recommended to use the final layout that requires no further editing or renewing from schematic. If you have a DipTrace license that limits the number of pins, you still can panelize identical boards even though you exceed the limitation, so the number of boards on the panel is limited only by the fabricator's panel size and usable area specifications. To panelize a board, go to Edit, Panelizing. In the pop-up, set the number of columns and rows. X and Y spacing depends on the depanelization method. If breakaways are going to be accomplished by using routed slots along with a series of mouse bites, you should set the value equal to the width of such slot, so I'll enter 2 mm, which is an optimal value in terms of costs, as most producers charge more for routing narrower slots. If you are going to use width scoring, then you can just leave it 0. But to set those values correctly, always consult with your fabrication house for specific requirements. Some manufacturers require panel border in the board outline layer, so I'll keep checked Show Panel Border checkbox. As a general rule, if you are going to assemble your board manually, components must be clear from the two long sides of the board outline by around 5 mm. But since we are going to prepare the panel for routing and automatic assembly, I'll have to add 2 mm for outer path and take into account the clearance requirements for fiducials and dueling holes. So the board outline to panel border distance sums up to 12 mm. Click OK. The software displays only the original board in the design area. All others are shown as numbered copies. But if you want to see all the copies as they are going to appear on the panel, you can open Preview in Gerber or NC Drill Export window. If you are going to order an automatic assembly of your PCB, you will need to place fiducial markers. Consult with your assembly partner for the required dimensions, quantities and locations. I'll place panel fiducials 1 mm in diameter with 0.5 mm mask opening. Basically, a fiducial is a surface pad with custom solder mask swell and without based mask. Just place a pad on your board using Place Pad tool, double-click and change type to Surface, adjust shape and size. Next, right-click on the pad and open Mask Paste Settings from the submenu. We are placing a fiducial on the top layer, so I choose No Solder option for the top paste mask. Then check Custom Solder Mask Swell and make it 0.5 mm. Apply to Current Pad and click OK. You can copy and paste the markers to distribute them on the panel. Select them all and specify Do not panelize in the context menu. In DipTrace, any components that consist of one or more pads but no shapes are excluded from pick and place file, so fiducials will not appear in your pick and place report. Tooling holes are also required by most assembly houses. Generally, 4 of them are placed in the corners. The hole should be around 3.175 mm in diameter, which is the standard pin support size. Just select Place Mounting Hole tool and put one in the corner of the panel. Double-click to open Hole Properties dialog and enter 3.175 for both the outer diameter and the hole diameter. Copy and paste the holes, select them all, and specify Do not panelize in the context menu. Now we need to create a router path with mouse bytes. To do that, we'll have to add an extra non-signal layer. Press Add Layer button, select non-signal layer type. Let's name it Router Path. You can choose a different color. And now press OK button. Double-click to select the layer. Let's zoom in. For convenience, I'm gonna customize the grid size and make it 0.25 mm. For mouse bytes, I'm going to place several holes 0.5 mm in diameter. Select Place Mounting Hole tool and put a hole in the design area. Double-click to set the required parameters and place several equally spaced holes. Now I'll group the mouse bytes to facilitate their copying and pasting and position them symmetrically to each other on the opposite sides of the board outline to form breakout tabs. Finally, I'll draw a router path. Press Place Shape button and choose the necessary tool. I'll use Arch for curved parts of the board outline and Line for the straight ones. Make the width 2 mm. Draw a router path segment and then continue creating a closed outline, leaving gaps only for the mouse bytes. The panel is ready for manufacturing and assembly.